It's Mario Day on the day of this video recording, and I can't think of a better way to celebrate than to jailbreak a Nintendo console. The GC Loader makes an ideal solution for this, but it's often sold out, so we'll need a plan B. I'll teach you how to plug in a specially modified GameCube save card, your GameCube controller, and an exploit game, in this case Agent Under Fire, to boot the Swiss custom operating system for access to your content your way. But come on, can you really jailbreak a GameCube in just 30 seconds? You sure can. Come on, I'll show you how it's done. We'll use a soft-modded Wii to copy over the necessary game save files onto the GameCube memory card. And it all starts by removing the SD card from your modded Wii. I have a link in the description if you need to learn how to softmod your Wii. This GC Forever Wiki page has a list of all of the exploitable games that can be used in this process. I have it linked for you in the description. I chose James Bond Agent Under Fire for this example because it was the least expensive at the time and gives you quick access to the Swiss menu from just a few button presses. With the Agent Under Fire exploit, all three of the downloads you need are hosted on the GitHub and linked for you in the description. On the Swiss GitHub page, scroll down to the Assets section, then click on and download the latest release of Swiss.7z shown here. Now that you've downloaded the softmod software, you'll need the exploit file. Again, linked in the description, hosted on the GitHub. This one's called Exploit Under Fire. Scroll down to the Assets section and click to expand if necessary. Then locate the latest release of Exploit Under Fire and click to download the file. Because your GameCube isn't modded yet, we'll need to use a soft-modded Wii in order to write those files to the GameCube memory card, and that's where GCMM comes in. It's hosted on the GitHub and linked in the description. Like the other pages, scroll down to the Assets section. Locate the zip file for the latest release of GCMM and click on it to download it to your computer. Each of the three files in your Downloads folder need to be extracted. You'll have two zip files and one 7z file. I recommend deleting each of the compressed files once you've extracted them in order to eliminate clutter and confusion out of your Downloads folder. You'll need the 7zip software in order to extract the 7z file. I have that link for you in the description below. Winning at GameCube modding is all about copying the right files to the right place on the Wii's SD card. With the card inserted, you'll need to make a new folder on the root. To do this correctly, make sure you're out of the way of any existing folders on the Wii's SD card. Then just create a new folder and call it MC Backup. MCBACKUP, all lowercase letters. Double-click on the newly created folder. This is where we're going to copy two save game files that are part of this exploit. Navigate back over to your Downloads folder and double-click into the exploit folder for the game that you're planning to use. There are liable to be several types of exploit modded game save files inside this folder. How are you supposed to know which one to choose? The answer to this mystery lies on the underside of your game disc in the center ring. Props to my wife for taking this excellent photo. DOL represents the Dolphin platform, which was the code name for GameCube. GW7 represents the game ID. E represents United States region. And the 0-00 means it's the original version of the game, or version 1.00. And of course, USA means USA. Back at the Downloads folder, we can now use this information to identify the correct exploited save game file. In this case, it's the one called GW7E. Oh, get out the way, stupid Windows information pop-up. There we go. It's the one called GW7E_V100.GCI. While you're still in the MC Backup folder on the SD card, just drag and drop that file, or the appropriate save file in your case, directly into that folder. Next, we need to copy the Swiss.GCI file that you downloaded previously in the Swiss download package. Locate that folder and double-click into it. You can ignore all of the other folders here except the one called GCI. Locate that folder and double-click into it. Locate the file called boot.gci. Click on that file and drag and drop it into the MC Backup folder on your SD card, just like you did with the previous file. We've got one more thing to copy over. Use the back arrow to go back to the root level of the SD card. This time, locate the Apps folder on the root of the SD card, and if you don't have an Apps folder, go ahead and create it. Go back to the Downloads folder and navigate back to the root of the Downloads folder. This time, double-click into the GCMM, or GameCube Memory Card Manager folder. Inside that folder, you're going to find another folder. go ahead and double-click into that folder also. In the list of folder choices that you're presented with here, locate the folder titled WII. Double-click into that folder. Now you'll have your choice of GameCube Memory Card Manager either in standard mode or in dark mode. You guessed it, I'm picking dark mode. Before you drag and drop it over into the apps folder on the SD card, make sure you do not have any of those folders selected or you'll put it in the wrong folder, which will be a subfolder. Now grab the version of your choice and drag and drop it into the apps folder on the SD card. Now that you have all of the files copied over from your PC to your Wii's SD card, eject the SD card from your computer and put it back in your Wii. On the left side of your Wii, fold down the expansion door for the memory card slots. Then insert the memory card into the top slot. That's slot number one. Then fold down the expansion door for the controllers and plug the controller from your GameCube into the rightmost port. Power on your Nintendo Wii and connect your Wiimote. Use the Wiimote to navigate the pointer to the Homebrew channel, then select it with the A button. Navigate to start and select it with the A button to launch the Homebrew channel. The list of apps shown on screen may vary depending upon what's on your SD card. In any case, select GCMM with the A button, then select Load to launch it. You'll be presented with the Wii GameCube Memory Manager main menu. It has a legend on the right side explaining what all of the buttons do. To copy over those two save files from your SD card, press the X button on your GameCube controller. You'll be prompted to select the memory card slot. We put it in slot A, so press the A button on your GameCube controller. You'll see the two GCI files in the top left corner that you copied over to the SD card, one being boot.gci and the other being your gamesaveexploit.gci. Start by highlighting boot.gci with the D-pad and then select it with the A button to install it directly to the GameCube memory card. Once the first copy over process is complete, press the A button to continue. This is going to take you back to the memory card manager's main menu. Once again, press the X button. And when prompted for the slot, press A for slot A. Use the D-pad to move down to your exploited game save, then select it with the A button to copy the save game over to your memory card. This should be almost instantaneous. Press the A button to continue. Once you have these two copied over, you're done with the Nintendo Wii. Power it off, unplug the GameCube controller from your Wii, and remove the memory card from memory card slot 1. And hey, don't forget to close those two doors. You do still have those two doors on your Wii, don't you? I know, bad joke. Let's move on. Insert the modified memory card into memory card slot 1 on your GameCube. Then plug in your controller and insert your exploit game. Again, in this case, it's going to be James Bond 007, Agent Under Fire. Power on your Nintendo GameCube. Once it gets through the boot logo, allow the game to start loading. As you saw at the beginning of the video, James Bond 007 Agent Under Fire takes about 30 seconds to go from the initial load screen of the game to Swiss. Here are the steps to take to expedite this process. Once you get past this MGM screen, immediately start pressing the A button on the GameCube controller. You'll hear a quick excerpt from the music and it'll immediately go to the next screen. Begin pressing the start button on the controller here to go directly to the main menu. When the menu appears, press down and press the A button. Then start pressing the A button on the controller. And whammo! You're loaded into Swiss in less than 30 seconds. This is great and all, but what's next? How about a magic act? Are you ready? Alakazam! I've just added a 128GB SD card for storing all of your favorite GameCube games. Want to learn how this is done? That video is going to be right here and in the pinned comment description as quick as it's ready. In the meantime, this video is pretty good too. Check it out.